Hey guys, welcome to Shorty's Complete DJ Method. I'm DJ Shorty, and this is the CDJ DJ Mixing Beginner Course. In this course, we're gonna cover manual adjustments, tuning your ears, beat matching, and then we're gonna work all the way up to some really cool blending and mixing techniques. So first of all, what's beat matching? Well, beat matching is lining up two or more audio sources, so two or more tracks, and you're literally lining up the beats together, the placement of the songs, the placement of the beats, so that they play in sync with each other. Now, speaking of sync, if you're using DJ software like Serato DJ or Tractor Scratch Pro or Rekordbox DJ, or if you're using DJ hardware, such as like a controller or even some CDJs that offer a sync feature that will automatically sync the tracks for you and beat match them for you, why would you want to learn how to beat match manually? Well, as a beginner DJ, it's an excellent way for you guys to learn to tune your ears, which is actually one of the hardest skills for DJs to learn. And it will also teach you what the software and the hardware is doing behind the scenes, which will actually make you a much better DJ overall, rather than some of the other new DJs coming up that only know how to press the sync button, and that's about it. So it'll make you a much better DJ. Another reason is that no matter how good the technology is and how high-end it is, it's still technology and it may screw up from time to time and you need to know how to fix it. So you don't want to be playing a gig and something get off or you nudge something, hit a button by mistake or the software messes up some way and then you aren't able to fix it and then you'll be up a creek without a paddle. So you'll be in trouble. So you need to know how to beat match by hand so that you can save yourself in situations like that. Also, at the time of making this video for you guys, some DJ software like Tractor Scratch Pro doesn't offer flexible beat grids, which means if the track changes tempo throughout, so say it starts at 1 BPM and then transitions to another BPM, it will only allow you to beat grid one of those BPMs, which means you'll have no choice but to beat match by hand on either the intro or the outro, whichever one you didn't beat grid. So that's super important. Now, if you aren't using DJ software or hardware that offers this feature, you have no choice. You have to learn to beat match manually. So these CDJs don't have a sync button. And if we weren't using DJ software with them, we wouldn't have that capability, which means we would have to beat match by hand. There's no choice. So you definitely gotta learn this skill. Now, why would you want to use sync if you already know how to beat match manually? Well, first of all, if you want to pull off like a super technical trick set where you're like mixing like every bar or every four bars or something like that, you may not have time to beat match manually, in which case you'd want to use sync that you can focus on so that you can focus on more creative aspects of your mix. If you're doing some sort of very technical set like that where it's switching between tracks and audio sources like super quick. Also, if you're using other gear in addition to your DJ equipment, so say you add in a drum machine or a synthesizer or something like that, then you will need to use sync in order to sync everything up. And then also, again, you'll want to keep yourself free most of the time. If you have so many things going on, you may not have time to beat match manually, in which case you'll definitely want to incorporate that sync feature. Now, I already taught you guys how to use the sync features in Serato DJ and Tractor Scratch Pro in those software courses. So if you missed those software courses or just don't remember, definitely go back and check those out to learn how to use the sync features with DJ software. This course is all about beat matching manually in terms of the beat matching aspect. And then later we're gonna move up to mixing and stuff like that in this course. But the beat matching is all manually. And I encourage you to learn both, practice both, because you can interchange both. I mean, you can go back and forth between beat matching manually and using sync throughout your set for different reasons. So it's really helpful just to be knowledgeable and learn all the different aspects and see what works best for you. All right, let's get to it.